Trojan Horse International presents Borstal Boy, a punk opera designed to be performed in prisons. This opera is based on the true story as told in the book Converted on LSD and its special edition Borstal Boys for prison inmates. Scene 1, Graffiti Wall. As the curtains open, Dave sprays Borstal Boy on the backdrop of the wall and is noticed by the policeman.
Oi, what do you think you're up to?
It's art, mate.
Oi, come back here.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this Festival of Anarchy. The international production company Trojan Horse proudly presents Borstal Boy. It tells of the trials and tribulations of a roustabout rascapalion, revolutionary by the name of Dave Clark. It's his story, a tale of misfortune and wealth, of love. Love turns sour, and through influence and bad choices, a life of petty crime and the events that turned his life around. Our story, like all the best of stories, come with music. Music performed by... They will help guide us across this murky river. Watch out for the gruesome characters of horrors that make up our players this evening. Most of them are bad characters, the like of which you would cross the road to avoid. Allow me to introduce you to one that is possibly the worst. It's Dave's elder brother, Mick Clark, a role model with no compassion nor responsibility, and he's in complete control of Dave.
Oi! What have you been up to running from the police? On the spray can. You know I like my fun. Now don't be so stupid. Don't take stupid risks. It's only a bit of fun. You know we've got it good, thieving and dealing, so don't do things to mess it up. So listen here, little brother. Let me explain how things need to happen. You want to be a legend like me? You need to listen. Listen? But I'm not so sure about stealing just for the sake of it. Yeah, I nicked a few bits and pieces, but I needed them for the band. Now stop being such a sissy. No brother of mine is going to be a fanny about robbing. Yeah, all right. I mean, I suppose it's not too bad. Maybe dealing a bit of blow, selling drugs to rich kids. Who gets hurt doing that? Yeah, I guess. I mean... And then, after that, I'll show you how to shake people down for money. Protection money, we call that.
You mean protection from other lads like us?
Yeah. And if you don't do exactly as I say, then you'll need protecting. But there'll be no other geezer around here to offer it, so you'll just have to clear out of town. Now, that's all right. I'll be all right. Yeah, I've got the wheels. I've got the reputation. And I'll teach you about how to be bad. Don't you forget it. I got complete control over you.
Suddenly, the coppers reappear.
We've been looking for you, Mick. Yeah, a nice bonus for us finding you. We'll deal with your little brother later, another time.
But Dave gets away. Dave now addresses the audience.
It's no good. My brother's got nicked. I need him. He keeps me on the straight and narrow. I love him. I'll do anything for him.
He just likes complete control.
Wrong place at the wrong time for old Mick. He's got it bad. Arrested and charged with stealing cars, he was found guilty and got sent down to Rochester Borstal. End of scene 1.